Hey guys, it's Fran with Jump Realty. Today I am inside because it is freezing outside. Talking about real estate today. This is traditionally a quieter time of the season. Halloween to Christmas, things tend to slow down just a tad. People don't want to move during the winter, not so much curb appeal. But having said that, it's Windsor. Market's still strong, market's still hot. As Damon said the other day with the news, supply, supply, supply. If you have a house, put it up. If you're looking for a house, still a good time to buy. That brings me to what I want to talk about today, which is investing. I've had several clients from out of town and in town talking about investing in properties. So just a brief overview for today. Two types of investing, buy and flip, buy and hold. So buy and flip, you buy a property, hopefully a little beat up, you fix it up and you sell it at a higher rate or appreciation and you make some money and you do it again. When you buy and flip, there's lots of things to know about that. But what we're going to talk about today just briefly is do the proper upgrades. Don't do a Mick flip where you paint it gray and white and put a granite tile on it and say, now I want $200,000 more. Make sure it's up to code. Make sure it's done right. Make sure you do a good job. You will get a reputation. You want to make sure that what you're selling is a quality product. That's the thing to make sure when you buy and flip. Buy and hold. Five things to remember. I wrote them down to make sure. Okay, you ready? Finding the right property, which is who you're gonna rent to. Is it on a bus line? Is it near a school? Do you wanna rent in South Windsor and it's a big house? Do you wanna rent out in Lakeshore? People expect more. You get higher rent, but they expect more. So find the right property for you, which brings us to number two, financing. What's your budget? What's your price range? Where the right property and your price range meet, that's your unicorn of a house, okay? Start small. You want to know what you're getting into. You want to get your feet wet. Don't be like, woo, I can do this. I saw it on the Scott on Channel 39 there. Super easy. It's a little more than that. Number three, when you do the upgrades and you get the property, do upgrades that make sense for a rental, not your house. You're not living there. You may be like, oh, I hate this paint color, but who you're renting to may not care about the paint color. What may be more important to them is having a stackable in-suite laundry. What may be more important to them is a security system, having motion lights, than, oh, let's like make the garden pretty, right? You want to put your money where you're going to get a return, and you're going to get a return in doing what's right for the rental, okay? So do the right upgrades. Don't do too many to start. Rentals have a different wear and tear than they would if it was you living there. Number three, managing it. Put your systems in place. You're going to get rent every month. You might have to pay your condo fees every month. You have insurance. Put systems in place so that things that happen on a regular basis get taken care of in a regular way. You will thank yourself later. Which brings us to number five, kind of the opposite of systems, is prepare for the unexpected. You own a rental property. You may go 3 or 4 months and nothing's going to happen. You're like, wee. But then you know what? The furnace needs fixing. The plumbing needs plumbing. You're responsible for snow removal and things like that. That goes along with the systems. Expect the unexpected. Plan for the unexpected, which means in that system that you have in number four, have an emergency fund and be putting into that emergency fund, even if it's $50 every month, so that when something does come up, and that may be your renter leaves unexpectedly, breaks a lease, and you've got to float that lease for a month or two. You want to be able to have the emergency funds necessary for that. So part of this is expect the unexpected. It's home ownership. Something's going to come up. Okay? So remember, the five things when you're buying and holding, general overview, are find the right property, get your finances in order, do the right upgrades, put your systems in place, and expect the unexpected. Okay. If you're looking for a rental or a residential or any property at all, give me a call. And you guys look for Franz on Friday. Okay. And we will see you then. Bye.